Good afternoon. My name is Shannon Rico, and I'm the Clinical Director for the Office of Developmental Programs, Central Region. Welcome to Critical Thinking for Critical Times. Our speaker for this session is Brandon P. Fleming. Brandon P. Fleming is a...
So, after sacrificing nearly every weekend and training in Atlanta for the past 10 months, learning higher level academic disciplines, such as philosophy, political science, sociology, and even rhetoric. Finally, here we are on the beautiful campus of Harvard University.
This is Harvard.
Hello, everybody. It's so good to be with you. My name is Brandon Fleming. I am the assistant debate coach at Harvard University, the founder and CEO of the Harvard Diversity Project, and author of Miseducated, a memoir, which is my new book, which will be releasing on June 15th. Thank you so much for being here. I'm really excited to be able to share with you for just a moment. And one of the things that I want to share in particular is the reason why I decided to share my story in the form of a book that I wanted to offer the world, which is what I'm going to be sharing with you a lot about today. And the reason why is because I earnestly believe that I've been called to be a voice for those who don't typically have a voice, for those who are typically overlooked. And we typically look at students who are different from us and people who are different from us. And it's difficult for us to understand their experiences to be able to serve them. And one of the things that I've learned in this journey is that stories change people more than data ever will. The reason why is because stories are the gateway to empathy. It's what allows us to step in someone else's shoes. It's what allows us to view the world through somebody else's lens and to understand other people's experiences. And we cannot serve people that we don't understand. And so today, I want to share a little bit with you about my story, which is the story of the power of equity. And I'm going to break that down. Langston Hughes, that he penned in 1926, when he said, "I am the darker brother. They send me to eat in the kitchen when company comes, but I laugh and I eat well and I grow strong. But tomorrow, I'll be at the table when company comes. They won't dare say to me, eat in the kitchen then. Besides, they'll see how beautiful I am and then they'll be ashamed." Langston Hughes's tomorrow is our today. Today is a time that we create a seat at the table or that we build a new table for the people who need to be there. Your responsibility as educators, as teachers, as leaders in any industry that you're in is to blaze trails in the spaces where we belong, to shatter every glass ceiling, to break down every barrier of opportunity, and to be intrusive in the spaces that are not inclusive. Equity is the tool that you can use to change the world. And I hope you'll always remember that. Thank you so much for your time. And I look forward to connecting with you soon.